reported the Congress, that the Maoist threat is now one such national threat. And it's the duty of the Congress to look at that.
We are looking at it. I mean, we are looking at it, and we are, I'm not being facetious, we are fighting it with all we've got. The government is fighting it with all we've got. There is a very serious and concerted fight against the Maoists. However, I have tremendous respect for Jyoti Basu. He's a towering national leader, has ruled West Bengal for so many years. But I don't agree with Nirodpal Basu that this is not connected with the elections. It's obviously connected with the elections. Fair enough, their vote base has shrunk in the last Lok Sabha from the previous Lok Sabha, has been going down. But I think that the whole question of this Maoist issue, it does not mean that all the people of West Bengal will have to vote for
so
the
you're CCIM. So you're saying...
I'm saying vote for the Congress, you know, vote for the Congress.
Not for
Vote
Mamata.
For the Congress alliance.
Vote for Congress.
For our alliance partner, obviously.
Okay, so you're suggesting that this is a sign of political insecurity in the left.
Indeed,
appeal.
I am.
But to the wider question of what this means for the anti-Naxal offensive or the policy, the approach towards Maoist violence... is the Congress worried that your ally, Mamata Banerjee, has been soft on the Maoists in the past, has supported organizations like the PCPA, now found guilty of hijacking that train recently, as we saw? Are you concerned about Mamata Banerjee's politics when it comes to Maoist violence?
You know, Barka, the fact is their own allies, if you're going to talk about it like in that fashion, the forward bloc leaders, you know, Ashok Ghosh, I've read in newspaper
were
reports.
In touch with Kishan
They
Ji.
Were in touch with Kishan
But that's
Ji.
Not answering my question. No, that's them. That's them. And their home minister has already said that they were comrades in arms
once. I was on a limited point.
That
we should not be pointing fingers at each other.
Are you concerned about your allies' politics?
No, today it is an all-out fight against the Maoists. This government will not be soft on the Maoists. I don't think any ally of the government, including Mamata, will be soft on the Maoists or on Maoist violence. In fact, if the CPIM, it does not certainly lie in their mouth, because they have not yet banned it. You know, they've not yet banned the Maoists in West Bengal. Many other states have done it. And therefore, it does not lie in their mouth to call upon us.
All right, we'll take that back to Nilotpal. But first, let's go across to Derek O'Brien of the Trinamool Party. Derek, there seems to be a perception that in the past, if it was the CPM that was soft on the Maoists, described by the Home Minister as former comrades in arms, today it is the Trinamool Congress. And people are pointing again and again to the support provided by your party, by your leader, to people like Chhatridhar Mahato of the PCPA, subsequently found guilty of the train hijack.
What's your question?
My question is... given that you've supported Mahato in the past, why should we believe that the Trinamool is not still covertly supporting Maoist sympathizers?
See, the Marxists and the Maoists are two sides of the same coin. Now, if you're even thinking of equating Mamata Banerjee's party with the CPI Maoists, it's as bizarre as me sitting here in your television studio and saying, Barkha, you are in cahoots with ZTV. I mean, it's as bizarre
this
as
is
that.
This is a
the
facetious answer.
In Bengal,
Derek, it's a clever facetious answer. It doesn't answer my question.
Barkha.
Yes.
Barkha, the situation in Bengal, either you take the Rajdhani hijacking, you start from Nandigram, you go to Lalgarh. Tubar.com.